making wishes. Was Robin trying to take our land again?
Yes, and then he got furious, and we had some words, and he turned black in front of the eye.
Forget about it, Sharon. Happens to him every time he sees a Negro walk by. He sees red, turns purple with rage, and yells himself black in the face.
Mr. Rockin seems to have a rainbow all his own.
Go, 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 go,
go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go,
go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go,
go, go, go, go, go, go, go,
all that free, all that gentle day. Cheers and robots. Last one down is feeling a chill. Nothing but a rat face still.
not here on pleasure, we're here on business.
My husband received your letter, Miss Lonergan. What do you mean you're not going to pay us for all those tractors and clothes we sent you?
But I explained that to you. Because I can't dig up me gold.
Why not?
I'm surprised at you people. Do you want to ruin free enterprise?
May it never be.
Well, what stimulates free enterprise? Incentive, right?
Right.
And what stimulates incentive? Gold, right?
Right.
Well, if you remove gold from the ground, you remove incentive. And if you remove incentive, you wreck free enterprise. Right?
Right.
And rest me case.
There's just one thing that's not clear, Miss Lonergan. How are you going to pay us for all this merchandise?
We can't discuss this in public. Step into me, private office. Secretary, we would like to be alone.
Would you mind waiting in the ante room, please?
Follow me, please. Shut the door. Suppose I do dig up the gold and give it to you. What will you do?
Send it to our bank in Chicago.
And what will they do with it?
Transfer it to a bank on Wall Street.
And what will they do with it?
Ship it to the Federal Reserve in Washington.
Now, what will the Federal Reserve do with it?
Bury it in Fort Knox.
That's the whole point. Me gold is already buried. And near Fort Knox. Now,
think of all the transportation Father is saving.
We don't like it.
Why not?
It's un-American.
We ain't going to think you've got any gold. What's the use of gold anyway? Can't make music.
Right.
Can't give milk.
Right.
It doesn't taste good with mustard. We're not in the mustard business.
We're dealing with crackpots.
We'll have you blacklisted in every chamber of commerce in the country. We're pulling out our equipment in the morning.
Oh,
don't be irritated. Have a lucky gold. That's no way to treat a lucky gold company. I just received an order for 40,000 bales of tobacco. Rainbow Valley tobacco.
Why should lucky gold order tobacco from a outfit like you?
Well, you've heard of the golden Christmas, the golden melody, the golden gold of lucky gold, haven't you?
They've always claimed that.
Well, when they heard about the gold in our land feeding on tobacco leaves, they realized it was true. Now they're shouting out in life. Look, click, slip, pick. And the National Enquirer.
Well, this order is all the gold mine anybody needs.
Good sound economics.
So, Rainbow Valley.
Hey, Ben, this calls for a toast. Sweetie boy, and Shadow, me darling. Me mission is accomplished now. Your rainbow is just around the corner. I'll be leaving soon. It would be me lifelong dream come true if I could see you happily married before I go. But of course, that's a decision no man can make for you.
How would next Tuesday suit everybody for the wedding?
Same Tuesday it is, and you're all invited. Formal dress required.
That's just the day we drink that treaty of fun with a little meeting.
Rich! Hey there, Mahoney! Where is he? Where's Watkins?
You got me, bud!
Why, I can't go around telling everybody he's resting in Wasatch Springs.
We ain't seen him since the day he was struck by lightning.
What's the deal?
all this junk. Anybody who hates people like Hawkins does, that triples on them.
I don't know what you're talking about. All I know, she wished it, and it happened. I'll give you till Tuesday to produce the body, or you're gonna have a murder rap on your hands. Come on, Bud, put that in your guitar and pluck it.
Woody, do you think I really wish to call the senator?
Let's face it, Sherry. Ever since you came to Rainbow Valley, strange things have happened. You've got to admit that.
I've been worried about it because.
Why, this whole place is lousy with flying birds. I felt it the first time I looked at you.
So what, Woody?
That sort of charm, glitter in your eyes. Sort of conjuring music in your voice. I've been bedeviled and bewitched ever since.
Well, then that settles everything. I couldn't possibly marry you.
Why not?
Well, our children might have, cloven hooves or two heads. You know, Father always said there was something about the
garden. He was right. Isn't it true that you booted me right out of that organizing trip?
Did I do that?
And isn't it true that you're standing there this minute, gloating over my elbows, making me honey in your hands, sweeping me off my feet?
Oh, Woody, this really is love, isn't it?
Shucks, no. It's just the moonlight in your eyes. Radiating thin.
You and your glass make this romance too hard to handle. Stars in the night, blazing their light, gamble a candle. Through your eyes of apple hue, got me flying high and wide on a magic carpet ride. Oh, the butterflies inside. What a cry, what a groove. What a laugh like a moon. In that old devil moon in your eyes.
Just when I think of
Do you think I want them to see me this way?
Well, I see nothing wrong with you.
You must be blind. Can't you see I'm black?
But of course, something is very becoming.
But I'm a white man. A white man. At least I was until a couple of days ago.
Oh, well, that's a coincidence. I was green until a couple of days ago. Don't you find an occasional change of color interesting?
No, I don't. And I tell you, they won't get away with it. They won't get away with it.
Don't be so excited. I think it's just ridiculous to make such a fuss about a person's color.
You moron. Don't you realize what it means to be black?
But you're still a human being. Still smell bee honey, and listen to bird music. A rose is still a rose, despite the color of your nose.
But you can't get into a restaurant. You can't get on a streetcar. You can't buy yourself a cold drink on a hot day. You can't even go into a church and pray.
Well, who says you can't?
Well, the law says you can't.
The law? Well, that's a silly law. It's a legal law?
Of course it's a legal law. I wrote it myself.
Oh, well, that's too bad. I know. Why don't you change your color again?
And how the heck am I gonna do that?
Well, you said you had to change a couple of days ago.
No, oh, I said nothing of the kind. The witch wished it on me.
Oh, a witch? Well, in that case, I can help you. What kind of a witch was she?
I don't know. I didn't look her up in Who's Who.
Oh, but I'm sure we can find her in Witch is Witch. This little book has a list of all the witches, their curses and cures. Now, let's see.
Go away, will you?
I think I understand your trouble now. You're too unfriendly.
Well, I'm in no condition for friendship.
And it's all that witch's fault. She gave you a new outside when she should have given you a new inside. Very uncomfortable. It'd give witchcraft a bad name. She could set up entire profession back 100 years. I'm afraid we'll have to alter your personality. My whole reputation is at stake. Stand up, sir.
Why don't you leave me alone?
This won't be a bit hard. All we'll have to do is broaden out that narrow mind a little,
reduce some of that bigotry, and your pomposity won't show at all.
Wait till you see you and your new spring psyche. But people will say you're in love. Now for the magic cure.
Fiddle fuddle, oil and fiddle, cure this fuddle, individual. Rise, ye vapors, and unwind this tangle, even mine. Breath of me, and bluebird wings, make this scowling spirit sing.
Laid away, don't let me have you my way, Dale. Please.
talking bingo.
Bingo. The fight begins. The red begins. The hope to shoot the red begins. The grief begins. The sweet begins.
Why even?
Now!
doorstep. Let's buy a fairy in the moonlight. Quite the age of two, she can talk with the skylarks and decode the chirping of the crickets. At the age of four, she can blow a rainbow out of a bubble pipe and then wear a hand-me-down sliding down it. Then, during her adolescence, she took a tragic turn. Think of the crisis, the crisis. She began to change whiskey into milk. From then on, one change led to another. And now you are all witnesses to the unhappy climax. She's changed a white man into a black.
Oh, for heaven's sake, huh?
I'm doing the right thing.
All right, men, change her away.
Not so many, gentlemen. Sharon can also change a black man into a white.
You mean she can make Hawkins white again?
It's a star. Let's get it over with.
She's better make Hawkins white again, or you're out of a job. You don't think that Hawkins is going to be re-elected in the condition that he's in, do you? And if he ain't re-elected, you ain't re-appointed.
Jesus, that's true.
I never thought of that.
What do we do?
What the hell?
Make Hawkins white again, ma'am. Well, I might have to.
Now, for Hawkins, I ain't done him white or any other color to keep a pack of crooks like you in office.
Calm yourself now, Billboard. You in no position to have opinions right now.
And who's in a better position? Boy, can I see both sides of this? Yeah.
But you got to see our side. Our whole livelihood is at stake.
Besides, Mr. Hawkins, as a Negro, you ain't got no rights.
Definitely not.
Not even the right to stay black. You got no rights.
But I can stay black if I want to.
I got congressional immunity. And furthermore, I refuse to be brought forth in any witchcraft trial as Exhibit A. And I'm progressive.
We can't afford to let go of him now. Time up,
thank you. but you. I feel better already. Being near you. Sense of your hair. The touch of your hand. Oh, the miracle of it. The sweet, sweet miracle of it. She loves me. Oh, Sharon, you are the only one. Oh, but you're not Sharon at all. You're Susan the Silent. And yet, I feel the same frenzy for you. Is this what it's like to be mortal? Is every girl the only girl? I'm beginning to like it. Oh, my heart is beating wildly, and it's all because you're here. When I'm not near the girl I love, I love the girl I'm near. Everything that bothers my mind is a flame that must be fed. When I get fondled, I surrender.
dancing minutes and save her at the last minute. More than that.
Oh, now! In heaven's name, now! It's life and death!
Well, very well. But I'll need only one little thing from you.
The speak man!
What is it?
What is it you need?
The crop of gold.
Give me strength! Give me strength to resist me on strength! To keep from throttling into death!
Land and usual 10% for me, of course.
Is Walter fine, mister?
The company dropped Bill from the board. Poor fella got his color back, but never recovered his sense.
Greetings, neighbor, greetings. And how are you on this bright and glorious morning?
Well, my, Mr. Henry, you're looking fine today.
See what I mean?
I'm a gold again. I'm a busy man. How about that gold concession deal?
100,000.
You know, 100,000.
Well, what do you mean by 100,000?
It's worth a quarter of a million if it's worth a quarter.
Well, what do you say, Miss Lonergan?
Well, I don't like this petty business. I accept.
Move right out of check,
bud.
But you're not with the company anymore.
No, sir, not with the people now. All part of my new platform. Anti-poll tax. A dam in every valley and a rainbow in every pond. And incidentally, I'm running up for re-election next November.
Here you are, Lonergan. A quarter of $1 million.
Endorse it to the relief fund for unemployed veterans on the block of Warren County, Ireland.
But Sharon!
Well, why not? There's plenty more where it came from. The crocks in the ground, all bright with the world.
Isn't he friends, buddy? You wish he was talking.
You mean you used the crocks to wish back Susan's house?
Well, it wasn't a cyclotron, huh?
Then you used up the third and last wish?
What match?
Can't you see? I'm all mortal now.
But there's a little gold cross. It's turned to worthless dross.
Well, sure. I'll show it to you.
It's the final crisis. Everything's collapsing about us.
Father, how can you say that? We still have caravan gowns, tobacco, and prosperity.
It's all temporary. This little room is founded on an illusion.
Trust me, Lonergan, just like I showed you.
Behold, the little gold pot which man has sat on so smugly for centuries.
Really, lady, it'd make a nice lamp.
Oh, man, put some light on me. Keep it as a souvenir of a dying age. Things are indeed hopeless. Hopeless.
But they're not serious. I'm ready for reconversion.
Do you know what's in this bag?
What?
A pair of socks and the face of Wall Street. A toothbrush and the wealth of empires. The world of tomorrow in the palm of my hand.
Why, that's just an ordinary piece of moonstone.
He's right, huh?
Ah, he's blind. He can only see what you're looking at. Inside this piece of stone is a whole multitude of gnomes, elves, and fairy folk, like neutrons and latent, and protons and photons, ready to go to work for you and bring you all happiness.
Gee, where'd you get it, Mr. McLonergan?
From a friend of mine named Nicholas the Nucleus.
Father?
Hi, lass. I've outlived Fort Knox.
So where are you going, Mr. McLonergan?
To Oak Ridge, Tennessee.
Snag! Snag! A rainbow!
Oh, hi. A brilliant rainbow. It never fails to rise when the McLonergans are down. I hand it over to you as Ford the First handed over his factory to Ford the Third. Sure, there's no longer a pot of gold at the end of it, but a beautiful new world under it. Make it shine for Sharon. Farewell, me friend. I'll see you all someday in Guatemala.
Sharon, where is Guatemala?
There's no such place, Woody. Don't leave Father's head. Go to every weeping willow.
Yeah.
You know, that's the charge. You know, a member of the white race, named Senator Rockins, to a member of the Negro race, by means of witchcraft.
Witchcraft? Still hunting witches, I see.
Well, there's a law against witchcraft in this state.
Yeah, passed in 1680. I think it's a bit obsolete by now. Don't you think about trying to change that law?
Yeah. She's gonna get a fair trial now, Woody.
Oh, I can see it now. A Sycamore Tree for a courtroom.
Well, what do you suggest? Letting her run around loose during the whole state flat?
Rest on, Sheriff. Rest that witch. All right, Alec, arrest her.
Not me. I'm just a deputy.
You're the sheriff. You're wasting time, Sheriff. Remember, elections are coming up.
Well, you're under arrest. I'm only doing my duty.
Let's change them into pumpkins and put candles in them, Sheriff.
Yeah. Don't try any on the pumpkins. You can't do this now. That's lizard dust.
Lizard dust? Witchcraft? Can you honestly accuse me of being a witch?
Don't let her be devil, you gentlemen. A witch she is, and a witch she's always. Who would know better than me, her own father, who found her on the doorstep set by fairy moonlight? At the age of two, she could walk with the skylark and be called the turpin and the cricket. At the age of four, she could blow a rainbow out of a bubble pipe and then wear her panties out sliding down it. Then, during her adolescence, she took a tragic turn. It was a crisis, a crisis! She began to change whiskey into milk. From then on, one change led to another, and now you are all witnesses to the unhappy climax. She's changed a white man into a black.
Oh, very safe, Tom.
I'm doing the right thing.
All right, men, take her away.
But just a minute, gentlemen. Sharon can also change a black man into a white.
You mean she can make Rockins white again?
It's a start. Let's get it over.
She'd better make Rockins white again, or you're out of a job. You don't think that Rockins is going to be re-elected in the condition that he's in, do you? And if he ain't re-elected, you ain't re-appointed.
Jeepers! That's true!
I never thought of that.
What do we do?
How much time do you feel you'll need to make Rockins white again, ma'am? I might have all the same time. You're Rockins.
I ain't done it white or any other color to keep a pack of crooks like you in office.
Calm yourself now, Bill Boy. You're in no position to have opinions right now.
Oh, yeah? Well, who's in a better position? Boy, can I see both sides of this question?
But you gotta see our side. Our whole livelihood is at stake.
Besides, Mr. Rockins, as a Negro, you ain't got no rights.
Definitely not.
Not even the right to stay black. You got to turn white.
But I can stay black if I want to. Yeah. I got congressional immunity.
Yeah. And furthermore, I refuse to be brought forth in any witchcraft trial as Exhibit A.
Oh, leprechaun!
don't you?
Why?
You're not sharing at all. You're soothing the silence. And yet, I feel the same frenzy for you. Is this what it's like to be mortal? Is every girl the only girl? I'm beginning to like it. Oh, my heart is beating hard, and it's all because you're here. When I'm not near the girl I love the girl.
Beloved will perish in smoke and flame. I told you I don't go to the grave. must have made a wish over the clock. And you must have seen her do it. Tell me, where did she stand?
Oh, dear. Can't hear.
I know. I'll tell her. Susan's title?
Well, it wasn't a sack of John, huh?
are.
Make sense of life on you. Keep it as a souvenir of a dying age. The things are indeed hopeless. Hopeless.
But they're not serious. I'm made for reconversion. Do you know what's in this bag? A pair of socks and the face of Wall Street. A toothbrush and the wealth of empires. The world of tomorrow in the palm of my hand.
Why, that's just an ordinary piece of moonstone.
He's right, Bob.
Why, he's blind. He can only see what you're looking at. Inside this piece of stone is a whole multitude of notes, L's, and variables, like neutrons and latent, and protons and potent, ready to go to work for you and bring you all happiness.
Gee, where'd you get it, Mr. McGonagall?
From a friend of mine named Nicholas the Nucleus.
Father? Are you leaving us?
Aye, lass. I've outlived Fort Knox.
Where are you going, Mr. McGonagall?
To Oak Ridge, Tennessee.
Snag, grab! A rainbow!
Aye, Phineas rainbow. It never fails to rise when the McGonagalls are down. I hand it over to you as Ford the First handed over his factory to Ford the Third. Sure, there's no longer a pot of gold at the end of it, but a beautiful new world under it. Make it shine, poor Sharon. Farewell, my friends. I'll see you all someday in Guatemala.
Sharon, where is Blackamore?
Well, there's no place for me. It's only in Father's head.
So do every weeping willow.
Thank you.
from the cartons.